180 will be equal to k upon 2.303 into function t. I have taken t on that side and then dividing it by 2.303, we can have equation y equal to 2.303, that is been converted here, log of, in the form log of to the base 10, log of a0 upon at equal to k upon 2.303 into t, where this time, the function x means time with which we are studying the rate of reaction at different time intervals, and here the function of the concentration, this is the function with respect to concentration. Now this equation is a straight line equation without an intercept on y-axis, and therefore graphically it is studied like this. Take different values of concentration change at different time and then plot a graph. Take the values of A0 initial concentration, values of initial concentration A0 upon concentration at different time to the base of course 10. On y-axis and take time on this x-axis and then plot a graph. Of course it doesn't have intercept, therefore graph will be like this. It will be a straight line passing through the origin because we don't have y-intersect. Now select any two points and from that we can calculate the slope of the equation. As we know, slope is equal to the points y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Here we can have, this is y2 value, this is, this one will be a y1, this is y2, y1, and these two are the values of x2, x1, and by that way we can calculate the slope. From the slope now, as we know that the slope is equal to, slope will be equal to k upon 2.303 or k equal to 2.303 multiplied by the slope of the graph which has been experimentally obtained. By this way we can calculate the value of k. Now the value of k obtained by this method, first perform the experiment. After performing the experiment and taking the readings of at at different time, then put it mathematically like this. Take the values of log of a0 upon at to the base 10 on y-axis, time on x-axis, and plot the graph. It will be a straight line passing through the origin, and you can get a slope which is equal to k upon 2.303, and therefore k equal to 2.303 multiplied by whatever amount, whatever slope we have obtained in the graph. By that way we can calculate the rate constant. If the rate constant that is been obtained by this method matches or it has same value with the value of k that we have obtained by integrated equation which we have written there, k equal to 2.303 upon t log of to the base 10 a0 upon at, if both values matches, then we say that the experiment and the reaction was the first order reaction. In one more form this can be calculated, that we can have a popular equation which can be compared with the straight line equation also, because this is also a equation of straight line but it is passing through the origin. where we have log of 2 the base 10 a0 upon at. But we can have still one more simple way of calculating it by taking, as I already told you, by converting that equation into an equation in the form of a straight line, y equal to mx plus c. For that purpose, let us take and rewrite the equation. If we rewrite the equation in the terms of that, that will be, I can write it here, log of a0 log of a0 upon at at 2 the base 10 will be equal to a0 upon at will be equal to kt upon 3.03. This also simply can be written, I will write it here now. Log of 2 the base 10 a0 minus log of 2 the base 10 at, which is equal to kt upon 2.303. But here the functions are at and T. AT is the change in concentration of the reactant and T is the time, and therefore we have to rearrange the equation log of 2 the base 10 concentration of AT. I can write it here by multiplying the equation by minus, and therefore log of 2 the base 10 a0, which will be equal to minus kt upon 2.303. Now the same equation can be written as log of 2 the base 10 concentration of at will be equal to minus k upon 2.303 into t plus log of, I am taking this to that side, log 2 the base 10 concentration a0. And this is the equation which can be compared with the equation of the straight line. This we can compare with the equation of a straight line, where this is the function y is a change in concentration, change of concentration of reactant. Of course, we are taking the log value of that. Mathematically, we are taking the log value. But for simplicity, I am telling this is the function of concentration. This is the function of time. This will be the y-intercept. This will be y-intercept. And from the graph, we can calculate the slope. And from the slope, we can have the value of minus k upon 2.303. We have plotted the nature of the graph here with this equation y equal to mx. Now I will plot the graph according to the equation y equal to mx plus c in that form of equation, where you will be having a graph like this. The concentration of the reactant at a time t, its logarithmic values are taken, log to the base 10 here. Now the time is taken here, and here automatically we will be having a y-intercept, and you will be having a nature of the graph is like this. This will be the nature of the graph, and here we will be having y-intercept. And when we get a y-intercept, we can get this value called as log of 2 the base 10 h0. This is the initial concentration. Now, once you obtain log of A0 to the base 10, then by taking the anti-log, we can calculate the value of A0 initial concentration. Now, again, determine the slope of the reaction. As I have already explained you, this is a Y2, this is a Y1, X2, X1, and therefore slope will be equal to Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1. Once you get the value of slope, then we know slope, which is equal to, look at there, minus K upon 2.303. So slope equal to this, therefore we can calculate K also. Therefore K will be equal to, this is a slope, therefore K will be equal to minus slope multiplied by 2.303. Again calculate the value of K. If the value of K is same graphically, if the value of K is same as been determined by the integrated rate law equation that we have derived, if in both the cases the value of K comes to be same, then we say that the rate of the reaction is a first order and experiment of that reactant changing into product as a first order reaction. Always remember that this integrated rate law equation has more advantages. It is more easy to determine the values by integrated rate law equation, because as we start the experiment and take out different concentrations by different indirect method, we go for that, and by knowing the concentrations at different time, we can calculate and determine the order of the reaction. This way it is been studied. So till now we have seen first method as an experimental method from slowest step. Second method is the differential form, but it is very tedious and difficult, and many a times it is nearly impossible to calculate by that way. The third and important is an integrated rate law equation by which we can determine the value of K, and if the value of K remains the same using this equation of first order mathematical equation which is obtained, then we say that the rate is first order. Third method is a graphical method. The same equations are being written in terms of a straight line. This is a straight line here in the form y equal to mx plus c, and by that if we get a value of k same as that we have obtained mathematically by the experiment, then we say that the rate is first order. Scientists have also discovered one more method for studying the order of the reaction. Now that is very interesting method of studying the order of the reaction. Particularly it has come from the radioactivity, the concept of radioactivity, where the radioactivity is the first order reaction. And from that the concept has come. Let us go for that. In that concept, we are measuring the time required for half the reduction of the concentration of the reactant from its initial value and the time required for that. So that is called as half life period. And by half life period, we can determine and we can also study the rate of the order of the reaction. The time during which the concentration of a reactant is reduced to half of its initial concentration is been defined as a half-life period. So let us go to define the order of the reaction according to half-life period concept.